Hello, my keto peeps. It's Samaya, and welcome back to my channel, I Don't Sugarcoat. Today, I'm going to show you guys how to make a very delicious rosemary and onion bread. So let's get started. Before we begin, today's video is sponsored by Wholesome Provisions. They're a company located locally right here in the US, and they specialize in making keto-friendly foods, two of which are now my two favorites and a staple in my keto kitchen, and that is their lupin flour and their allulose sweetener blend. Check out their website and the rest of their catalog of products, from cereal to chips to chocolate chips and even sprinkles. I'm sure there's something on there that you guys will love. You can purchase their products on Amazon, or you can get them directly from their website. I'll leave their link in the description of this video. Now let's begin this recipe. All right, to start this recipe off, we are going to begin by adding some lupin flour to our bowl. And I will be using the miracle flour here. And I'm going to be using 3/4 of a cup. Next, I'm going to add 3/4 of a cup of some oat fiber. And to this, I'm going to be adding 1.5 cups of some wheat protein isolate. And this one is the 8,000 version. And the reason why I'm using this instead of using Vital Wheat Gluten is, one, I'm trying to cut down on carbs a little bit more. Now I have used this. I haven't used it in a while, mostly because I'm very impatient when it comes to ordering things. So, you know, ordering from Amazon, I can get my stuff same day, one day, or even in 2 days, but you cannot purchase this on Amazon. I buy it from Nutrition, however you pronounce their website. That's where I purchase it from, but you can purchase this from other websites. I just use that one in particular, and I'll leave a link to that in the description of this video. You will have to wait a little bit longer, depending on where you live, or you can pay extra to get it sooner. And so that's why I don't typically tend to use this, because I don't like paying extra for the shipping, but I'm going to be using this a lot more just because I'm playing around with new recipes. And I want to cut down on my carb count. So I'm going to be adding this. Oh, this is a zero net carb count product. So that's why I will be adding this to my bread today. Now, this is a wheat protein isolate. This is not the gluten. So I will be adding just 1 tablespoon of some gluten. I feel as though it really does help with the texture of the bread versus when I didn't use it and after I made it and I did use it. So just one tablespoon will be enough. So I'll be adding 1 tablespoon of some Vital Wheat Gluten. And now to this, I'm going to be adding 1 teaspoon of salt. I have 3/4 of a teaspoon of xanthan gum, and then I have 3 teaspoons of some baking powder. Now to add in our flavorings. Now, the point of me making this bread is because it's going to be for my southern dressing and my stuffing recipe. So this bread will be getting turned into croutons. So that is why I'm flavoring it. You don't have to do that if you don't want to, or you can pick and choose which one you want to add, or you can add a completely different flavor to this bread. It is entirely up to you. So I'm going to be adding 2 tablespoons of some rosemary, dried rosemary. And then I'm going to be adding 1 tablespoon of some onion powder. And I'm going to be making this in my bread machine today. And I know that I don't have to pre-mix my ingredients like this, but it's a force of habit. And I just prefer to do it because it just makes me feel like all my ingredients are getting well incorporated instead of letting the machine do it. I just prefer to do it myself. So if you don't want to do this step, you can totally just go to adding your ingredients into the machine. But I like to mix my dry first. And I've only used my bread machine on my channel maybe once or twice, so you might not notice, but I have upgraded to a different brand. Before I had a Cuisinart, and now this one here is the Breville, and I just love this thing, you guys. I absolutely love it. I absolutely adore it. The only thing that I would change about this machine is I wish it had a bit of a wider shaped loaf pan, but other than that, everything about this bread machine, I love. It gives me everything that I want, especially this little collapsible paddle right here. So that way I don't have to go digging it out of the bread. I love that. Okay, and so now I'm gonna add in 2 2/3 cups of some hot water here, and my water is at 130 degrees. Now, I get asked this question a lot about, will it kill the yeast? No, because the particular type of yeast I'm using is rapid rise yeast, and that yeast likes water that high. Can you use rapid rise yeast with a lower temp water? Yes, you can, but it will take your whatever you're making, it will take longer to rise. There are different types of yeast, so make sure that the type of yeast you have is rapid rise if you're using 130 degree water. Because if it's active dry yeast, that yeast does not like water at that high of a temp, and it will kill your yeast. I think for active dry yeast, it's somewhere around 100 to 110 degrees. That's the max for that yeast as far as how high you want to take the water. But again, with that yeast, you can use lower temp water with that. It will just take a little bit longer to do the rising. So as I said, this is perfectly fine. I use this temperature of water with rapid rise yeast all the time. I never have an issue with rising. The only time I've ever had an issue with the rising with this yeast was when my yeast was outdated, and so I needed to get fresh yeast. Other than that, I've never had an issue with fresh yeast, rapid rise yeast, and using it with this temperature of water. So now that I've added my water, I'm going to be adding 4 tablespoons of some olive oil. And I'm gonna just add in just a teaspoon of honey. And while you don't need to add in honey necessarily to activate rapid rise yeast, I still like to do it as a fail-safe. So I always do it. You can choose to do it or not do it. I'll leave that up to you. And so now we're gonna go ahead and add in our bowl of flour, or you can just add in the dry ingredients one by one. I would say add in all your flours first, then add in the salt and all that stuff and the seasonings last. Now, sometimes I do pre-mix my yeast when I bake breads. It's a force of habit. And sometimes I follow the instructions of the bread machine. I've been trying to get more in the habit of that. So I will be sprinkling 1 tablespoon of rapid rise yeast on top of my bread here. Well, not my bread, but my dry ingredients. I'm gonna sprinkle that on there. And now I'm gonna place my basket back inside my bread machine. And now I would tell you to use, with your bread machine, I would say use the low carb bread option. I think that would probably work best. I'm not sure about the gluten-free one, but I would say use the low carb bread option. With mine, I'm able to modify the settings, which is why I love this machine so much, because I can modify it, or I can create my own custom settings. So I have modified my settings here because I don't want this to punch my bread down. Now, it's fine if you have a bread machine that will do it once, but some of these will do it twice. And in my experience, low carb breads don't really like more than one punch down. And I usually don't do it at all, just so I can make sure it has a nice high bake on it. So I'm gonna take out the punch down on this cycle and leave everything else the same. If you don't have a bread machine and you wanna make this recipe, just follow the directions of my other bread recipe, and I'll leave a link to that in one of these corners, I'm not sure, I think it's this corner maybe, you'll see a link come across the screen in one of these corners. And I'll leave a link to that so you can follow the steps of how I make that bread. And you can do it exactly the same way if you're gonna be using your KitchenAid stand mixer and then just bake it off in the oven the exact same way. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn mine on. I have mine set to basic rapid rise. So if you have a Breville, you're gonna wanna go to basic, rapid, and you're gonna want to do a medium crust, 2 pounds, a 2 pound loaf, and you wanna pick those options for any bread machine, unless you want your crust a different color, then choose whatever crust setting you want, but make sure you choose a 2 pound loaf. And then I took out, like I said, the punch down option. So if you have a Breville, you may want to do that. You wanna hit the modify button and just scroll through, leave everything the same, and just take out the punch down option. I did do one other thing. I added an extra 5 minutes of bake time to this just to make certain my bread gets done all the way, but I'll probably end up checking it before that extra 5 minutes gets going. And so I'm gonna go ahead and start this, and I'll be back when this is done and show you what our bread looks like. Here is my bread fresh out of the bread maker, and it smells absolutely delicious. Now, I did end up doing a little bit of a manual punch down. I didn't punch the dough all the way down, but I thought it was getting too much of a rise, and I was concerned about it rising up too much, and especially when it gets to the baking part. So I tapped it down just a little bit, and you might need to do the same. However, it didn't really need it. You know, when you look at it, the loaf only ended up being this tall. And originally it was like up to here, but it was really early in the rising process. So I was a little bit concerned with, you know, how much more it was gonna rise. I should have just left it alone. But either way it goes, this bread is simply fantastic. One, it's gonna taste terrific. But as I said before, this bread will be going towards making my keto southern style dressing and my keto stuffing. So this whole loaf is going to be turned into croutons, and you will see it again when I make those two videos. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to cut into this just so you can see a slice of the inside, and then we're going to wrap this thing up. Now, as I said, it is still very hot, so I'm going to be really careful cutting into this. Now, I really shouldn't be messing with this bread while it's so hot, but I want to go ahead and get this video wrapped up because I've been filming for hours and I need to take a nap. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what this bread looks like. You can probably see the steam. It is so hot. It really does need to sit and cool. But I just wanna go ahead. Oh my goodness, it is so hot. I'm not even sure if I can handle the slice right now because it did literally come out not that long ago. But maybe I can get like a spatula or something and put it on there. Okay, so I've got a spatula. Let's try to just quickly grab it without ruining it, hopefully. Okay. All right. Now look at that slice of bread. Can you see that from up top? Now it would have been, if you asked me, it would be much more beautiful because it would have risen out to about here if I hadn't messed with it. But still, this is a gorgeous slice of bread. It looks really, really good. It's so, so, so hot. It looks good, it smells good, the crumb on it is really good. And this is gonna make perfect crouton bread, let me tell you. So there's one other thing that I wanna show you before I get out of here. And this has more to do with my bread maker. If you don't have a Breville, if you've been thinking of maybe upgrading to a different bread machine, here is why I really, really love that machine. Well, one of the reasons, it has several. One being that it has a light on it, you guys. I love that, to be able to push that light and look into the window and see what's going on without opening the lid. I love the light. But here is the hole that it leaves. It's not too bad, really. This is where the paddle, ooh, it's hot. This is where the paddle folds over and it lays down and the bread just easily slips out. I really prefer this to having to go in and dig it out of the bread, because then it's really deep into it and I just don't like it that way. And so this, I prefer it this way. It's not too bad to me, especially because this larger part is mostly surface. So it doesn't go inside the bread, really, not at all. And then you have this smaller indentation right here, but even still, it doesn't really break into the bread. It's gonna still cut very beautifully. So that's all I wanted to share about the Breville, the Breville bread maker. So if you're thinking about getting one, I'm gonna leave a link for it in the description of this video. No, I'm not sponsored by them, but I really do love it. So I wanted to share that with you all. But that is gonna be it. That's all I've got for you guys today. So if you like this video, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up. If you want to see me make more videos like this, click that subscribe button and don't forget to ding that little bell so you can get notifications every time I upload a new video. And until next time, you guys, bye.